Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I'm frustrated. Why am I frustrated? I'm glad that you asked. I'm frustrated because our productivity is being challenged at every turn. One of the things that is bothering me the most these days is notifications. I may be too much of a social butterfly and be signed up for too many social networks, but really, do they all need to notify me on all of my devices all of the time? No, they don't. But it's my responsibility to turn off those notifications, just like it's your responsibility to take control of your notifications. So today, we are going to be looking at turning off notifications on all of your devices on Ask Dotto Tech. You are constantly asking me for better ways to be more productive, and this is, in my mind, kind of one of the keys is overcoming distraction. Now, there's a lot of ways that we have to overcome distraction, allowing us to concentrate more effectively on what we're doing. But one thing that we can all do is turn off notifications. Now, perhaps you have such incredible self-discipline that seeing a notification appear in the top right-hand corner of your screen or buzz on your phone does not bother you. If so, good on ya. But for the rest of us, we need to find a way to deal with all of these notifications. So let us dive in. We're going to show it to you on Mac, on Windows, on iPhone, and on Android. We are going to do a notification blitz today. Let's start on the Mac. And in the Mac, if you head into your system's preferences, you'll find the notifications setting there. Now, this tells us how to manage each of the notifications coming from our apps, which is really where most of the problem comes from. And to be honest, most of the problem comes from just a few apps. I'm talking to you, Facebook. So here's how we can manage it. First of all, did you know you have a do not disturb? You can actually set times that notifications will not appear by choosing the do not disturb. Plus, you can at any point manually turn on do not disturb just by clicking on the notifications bar here. And then if you scroll up, you see it's always hidden. But if you scroll up, then you can turn on the do not disturb, and that means that nobody will disturb you till the next day. You can do that if you just want to temporarily disable everything, but a more permanent solution is probably called for. In that case, go into the notifications area here, go in and choose the offending notification and determine whether or not you actually want to be notified on your computer of it at any one point. Now, there's three different types of notifications. At least Facebook has three different types here. You can turn it off completely. You can just allow for ban, and you can allow for alerts. And they tell us what happens with each one. None is, of course, none. Banners are the ones that pop out and slide out from the side of your screen. And alerts basically are pop-ups that happen on the screen and usually interrupt a process. You have to finish them off. You have to click on the alert before you can move on so you can go through. And understanding that all of those alerts are happening, you can control them all from the notification screen. Awesome, Steve. What's up next? Well, let's talk about on our smartphone next, shall we? Because on said smartphone, a lot of notifications appear. Now, you get them in a lot of places. Now, people freak out when they look at my screen because I've got lots of badge notifications. Those are the ones that tell you how many emails or how many messages are in each of your different areas. That doesn't bother me. If it bothers you, you're going to want to turn them off as well, but it doesn't bother me too much. Now, basically, on iOS, in order to get to all of the notifications, again, just like in the Mac, they have a notifications screen. If we tap on that, you can see all of your different apps that are authorized for notifications. Now, you can avoid a lot of this problem when you initially install an app because they all ask for permission to send you notifications. Just say no. It's not that hard a thing to do. No, no, no. Try it yourself right now. One, two, three. See? You can do it. I knew you could. But go through, and again, if we tap on any of these, let's say Agora Pulse, which I actually want to have my notifications, there we see a roster of all of the notifications, whether it will show in the notification center. By the way, the notification center on the Mac is what we drag down from the top, and it gives us kind of all of the last messages that have been coming into our phone. So it allows us to show in the notification center whether or not we want to have a beep attached, the badge app icon, which creates that little counter that attaches to the icon of the application on the phone, which drives so many people crazy, is there. And it basically walks you through each of the different styles of notification you might have for that individual app. What's my best recommendation? Go through and only have notifications for things that are absolutely essential. I would leave probably notifications on for texting, of course. Phone calls, you might want to leave it on for email, and then you're going to have to choose whether or not you want it for Facebook and Messenger and all of those other apps. But you can reduce the amount of distractedness that you get by turning it off. So don't complain that you're constantly being distracted if you, now that you know that you can actually turn off said distracted things. Now, let's have a quick look in the wonderful world of Windows. If you go under your settings, you're going to find something quite similar. You go into the systems settings, and there we have notifications and actions. And just similar to what we find in iOS and or the Mac operating system, you can see here that you can see all of the different applications that are running. Now, I've got a very virgin install of Windows 10 running because I don't use Windows a lot. But this is where you go in and you can actually turn on and off all of the notifications for the individual apps if I had any apps that were notifying me. Windows 10 users, you can gain control as well. Now, I know what you're asking. Okay, you've covered iOS, you've covered Apple, you've covered Windows. What about Android, Steve? What about Android? Let's take a look at how we deal with notifications in Android. Now, on my Samsung phone, if I swipe down, it brings me into the notifications area. And here I've got the gear icon, which brings me into the settings. This is the exact same as going into the settings through the main interface. But in settings, we find sounds and notifications. That rings a bell, doesn't it? Scroll on down and sounds and notifications, and there's our notifications choices. We allow to set it up for do not disturb. We can determine what we have on the lock screen, and we also have app notifications, which, surprise, surprise, work almost identically to how they work in iOS that we showed you just a few moments ago. Any installed apps that have permission to give us notifications are listed out here, so we can go through it. We can take a look at the same app we were looking at in iOS, Agora Pulse, and here we can turn on or off all of the different notifications, and we can gain control over who's bothering us and when they were bothering us. The bottom line with notifications is they will affect your productivity unless you have some sort of colossal concentration and discipline where you simply don't notice them. Personally, I do notice them, so I need to turn them off on my different devices, or it will just, I'm like a magpie with a bright shiny object. What's up? Oh, that looks more interesting than what I am working on at this point. I hope you found this video to be useful. Now, I have to ask you a favor, is if you have any questions that you'd like me to incorporate in the Ask Dotto Tech feature, just post that question in YouTube comments, or if you're subscribed to our newsletter, just reply to our newsletter with your question, and if I can, I will incorporate it in an upcoming episode of Ask Dotto Tech. Now, there are three ways for you to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this YouTube channel. The second is please subscribe to our newsletter. That way you hear about my upcoming live events, tutorials, trainings, and the comings and goings in the Dotto Tech world. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel supported by the generosity of you folks at the crowdfunding site Patreon. Please drop by our Patreon page, have a look, and discover what perks you can get for supporting Dotto Tech. Those perks are awesome. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming the castle.